Good morning from New Hampshire. Today, going to be hiking the most photographed mountain in New Hampshire, Mount Chocorua. I'm going to butcher that name throughout the video. For a full trail guide of Mount Chocorua, you can check the link in the description below. So we're here at the Piper Trailhead, and the summit, as you can see, 4.5 miles away. We're going to be making a loop out of this hike. So we're going to be taking the Piper Trail up. We're going to TBD on what trail to take down, but there are a couple of different options, as well as some shelters you can stay at along the way. I've got the whole gang with me here today, Jack and Juno, for my birthday hike. So excited to get after this one. I've never hiked this mountain before, even when growing up here. Mount Chocorua. As I said, I'm gonna butcher this name throughout the video, but it is the most photographed in New Hampshire, apparently, but it's not from this trailhead. There is a viewpoint basically that has Chocorua Lake and then the mountain behind it, which is very, very pretty. Juno's been cooped up in the house for about 3 weeks now because we just haven't been able to get her on a good hike. And so today she's gonna go ham. You can already tell it's gonna be a good day for her. Mount Chocorua is gonna be, depending on how you hike it, anywhere between 9 and about 11 miles round trip, and just about 3,400 feet of elevation. The top is pretty rocky, so you're gonna wanna make sure you're coming on a day where it's either dry or rain is not in the forecast, because, you know, it can get slippery up there. But I'm actually really excited for that part. That's one of the reasons I chose this mountain today. This is where your variations start, just about a half mile into the hike. So as you can see, if you head left this way, you have some other options. We're gonna stay on the Piper Trail and just head straight up. I will link a full map of the area in the link in the description below, so you can check out all the variations of this hike. Your next trail junction here, you're gonna wanna get off the Piper Trail for the first time today and basically head over to the Carter Ledge Trail to the right. This junction that I just showed you is about a little over a mile into the hike here. If only it was that easy for everybody. Yeah, you're gonna pick up some serious elevation here once you take that trail junction. Next trail junction, pretty obvious. Mount Chocorua over here. Look at this guy. Little mushroom. While we're talking about mushrooms, I don't know how my brain works, but I started thinking about gear because of wetness. So I said earlier that you're gonna want to make sure the trail is kind of dry for this one. I'd recommend a good pair of hiking shoes or boots, hiking poles. We have them today. Haven't used them yet, probably on the way down though. And, you know, of course, backpack, food, water, and then a map or some kind of GPS, because there are a lot of trail junctions, and if you don't have my video to watch or you just can't remember, it's good to have a map. For everything we're using today, you can check the links in the description below, in addition to all virtual Sherpa gear as well, to help support the channel. Just poking above tree line, look at this beautiful look at the summit right there, right in front of you, the obvious one. Absolutely gorgeous up here. Look at this. Crazy. So soaking in these beautiful views. Crazy. After your beautiful glimpse of the summit on those flat rocks there, you start a descent before some flat and then heading up Middle Sister first. Definitely back in the trees for now, boulder hopping, but expect more elevation gain here. I've been trying to show you guys some of the moves that dogs need to make on this one by showing Juno a bit more than usual. This one is kind of a mix if your dog is okay to come on this or not. We've read people who have not brought their dogs, and then we've also read people who are like, it's no problem. So we're bringing Juno today. We have pretty high confidence and knowledge of her abilities, so we're just letting her do her thing, and it's been pretty easy for her so far. The move Jackie's going up right now, we had to help Juno up, just as a FYI. But so far, other than that, it's been okay. It was just a tall kind of jump for her.
Jump for me too.
Tall jump for Jackie as well, she said. So you got your final trail junction before you reach the summit of Mount Chocorua. You're gonna go left here, and it's about 0.3 miles to the summit of Middle Sister, and then another mile or so from there to the summit of Mount Chocorua. Summit of Middle Sister here. You get a good preview of the rest of your route over to Mount Chocorua to the left. Otherwise, beautiful views pretty much in all directions right now. 360 degree. Another beautiful day up here in the White Mountains of New Hampshire. So just gonna take a quick break here, get some water, and then head over, keep going over to the summit. It's about a mile away. Look at the old fire tower here. You can kind of take a look to the foundation. Pretty cool. Check out the views from it. As you can see, you have a bit of a descent before regaining the ridge and heading back over to the summit. Earlier in the hike, I showed you a trail junction, and you could have gone straight instead of right. And if you had gone straight, you basically would have joined the mountain kind of in this middle part that we're working to, and avoided the Middle Sister summit and some of that scrambling. Let's talk about the scrambling for a second now that we're done. It was pretty fun. There's definitely a lot of water on the trail, which is to be expected, especially this year with so much rain, which made it a little tricky for Juno in a couple spots. I showed you one where we had to pick her up and help her, but the other one I couldn't just because it was a little too precarious. But overall, I'd say if your dog is good at rock hopping and scrambling, definitely dog friendly so far. We'll see if that changes from now to the summit. another trail junction here. You don't want to go that way. You just kind of want to continue straight or bear left here. Stretch towards the summit. As you can see, some good scrambling. Just gonna follow the people trail to the summit. So as you get to the summit, there's a number of different ways to go. Where all the people are is actually not the trail, but you can certainly scramble that. The trail is actually to the right, then goes up. But as you can see, it's a little more fun for scrambling, so we're gonna give it a go. If it's too hard for Juno, we'll just go down and around. It's a little too tricky. I'll show you. Definitely some class 3-ish, maybe 4. So Jackie's just gonna take Juno around the side here, and we'll meet her at the summit. Pretty much the summit of Mount Chocorua here, just enjoying the views up here. It is beautiful. You can see over to Washington and the Presidential Traverse. You can see to all the lakes in the area. Just a ton of beautiful views up here. Awesome hike. So as you get to the summit, there's definitely some variations that are not dog friendly, and we had to pick up Juno a couple times, but I would say overall, for a dog that can hike in the mountains, aka is comfortable jumping around, doing some scrambling, this is a dog friendly hike so far. We'll see how the trail down is. We're going to be going a different way down. Just about 4.8 miles to the summit here, and yeah, pretty straightforward, well signed the whole time, and a nice large summit area to kind of carve your own space, even when there are a good amount of people here, but nowhere near what you'd find on like Adams or one of the 4,000 footers here in New Hampshire. Honestly, this is one of the best hikes I've done in New Hampshire. The views up here are phenomenal. The scrambling was pretty fun. And yeah, I mean, the terrain, just in all directions, the views are awesome today. Of course, you want good weather when you're doing this. The summit block's just right up that way. Once you get down here, if you want to go back the same way you can, go right. Otherwise, take the Hammond Trail, and you're going to go this way. As you reach this trail junction here, Hammond Trail is going to go this way. Jackie's coming from the wrong way because we got a little bit off trail. This is the Jim Liberty cabin here. Brief little history of it, but basically it was a three-story hotel. Storm knocked it down, they renovated it. Pretty cool. So just a brief look, you can camp in here, just no campfires allowed. Pretty cool spot to camp. The cabin sleeps 9, and I'll have more information about it on the full hike guide, again linked in the description below. This doesn't look like much, but it's actually a pretty critical trail junction. So we've been on the Liberty Trail this whole time here. It continues on this way. If you did park at one of those trailheads, that's where you'd want to go. If you didn't, you're going to want to go straight and basically pick up the Hammond Trail. The reason I say this is a somewhat critical trail junction is because if you go the wrong way here, obviously you're going to end up on a completely different side of the mountain. Pretty noticeable difference between this side of the loop of Mount Chocorua and the other side. This trail, I think it's the Hammond Trail right now, from the Liberty above, is just really leisurely, just kind of like meandering along in the forest. No big elevation gain, pretty much flat, and that's why I believe this half is longer than the other half. Second to last trail junction of the day here. If you wanted to go tag a bald mountain, you could go up this way. Otherwise, you're going to want to take the Weetamoo Trail this way. Almost at the end of the hike here, and you're gonna have sometimes maybe a creek crossing. Today, more like a full-blown river crossing here. Find your way wherever it works best for you. For us, I think I'm just gonna send it right across here and we'll see what happens. Hot start. I cannot believe that didn't break. Oh my God. So as you can see, there's numerous ways to do it. I cannot believe that log didn't break. All right, back at the Piper Trail now. Finish off the hike, you're just gonna wanna go right. Trailhead is just about a little over a half mile away. I'm almost done with this video. I still can't say the name of this damn mountain. Chocorua, I think, Mount Chocorua. Overall, I would say that the first half of the loop was much better than the second. Just way more scrambling views, etc. This loop is only gonna end up being about 9.2 miles, which is odd because the sites we read say 10 plus. Jackie and I both enjoyed this, just didn't love the trail down, but you trade off the views and some of the scrambling with a much easier trail overall. So that's nice on your knees and legs and stuff. As always, for a full trail guide, everything you need to know about Mount Chocorua, what is it? Of Mount Chocorua. You can check the description of the video linked below to my website, thevirtualsherpa.com. If you're new to the channel, check out some of my other videos here. I have hikes all across New England and based in Colorado. So obviously a ton of stuff there, national parks, etc. Go ahead and check the playlist out for more New England hiking. As always, thank you very much for watching. Jackie, Juno, and I will see you on the next adventure.